Good morning, cosmetology instructors. Hope you're doing fabulous. All right, so I've got my table set up for, I got here a little bit early today. Super tired though. All right, so I have my telling the story of the nail shapes. The mom and the dad had a little girl and then she grew up. And I have a video of this already, so I'm not gonna record that lesson because it's already on the channel. But today I'm going to change it up a little bit. So usually I have the students, where's my box? I got this little index card. You can use regular index cards, but I got this little index card box like that on Amazon. And so I got stuff at Google and laminated them. And they're gonna need 7 of these little cards. And in the past I would have them, and I have my little sample, which is not complete, but I would have them, they would get 7 little cards, title each one, put their name, and they would have to do 10 tips. But today I'm gonna do a little different. I'm gonna have them label it, do a diagram of the nail, describing the nail, and then just shape one nail, and then take one of the glue dots and stick it down on the card. So I've all the supplies out, I have my notes out, and then the screen is ready. I'm cutting up the strips of the glue dots here, and supplies are in the back. I hand out the nail files and the nail tips, just because we talk about them as I pass them out. All right, see you in a little bit. Hello, look what I found. These are my absolute favorite. And seniors selling them, so I caught a senior in the hallway. I have a treatment in my hair that I need to rinse out. I put it on last night and I haven't had time. I said, I'll get to school and rinse it, or I'll wash my hair in the morning. It didn't happen. Anyway, so I have another cart full of stuff. It's coming in. After school, I set everything out. I handed out, I don't like asking for help because I like to put my eyes on everything, and it helps me remember what I have. And anyway, 2 trusted students, had them help me during reboot time, take everything out of the boxes and all the packaging stuff. So that way I can get through it faster. I just went to go pick up this. So now I got unpacked that. I still have to do my, it's just a lot. In the morning, it worked really good, really well with the lesson for today. It worked out great. I'll post that whenever I get a chance to. We talked about the story of the little girl and her nail shapes as she goes through life. I have everything ready for, as I prepped yesterday before I left, everything ready for this afternoon. I just have to move the tables and put the table cloth out, or the table cover. So I'm gonna go to the bathroom, do that. Need to go pick up lunch. Need to unpackage this stuff to put all these things away. Tomorrow we have, it's Thursday. Tomorrow I'm gonna prep for the father-daughter braid workshop. So I need to request a big TV screen that I can put in the manicure area so I can set up stations there. I need to fill the boxes with the bobby pins and rubber bands. Luckily those just came in. Get all the brushes and things ready. Get out all of the princess supplies, which I have in the closet. It's a big mess in here right now. I have this one that Miss Martinez made. So I have a box of princess stuff, and I have somewhere, oh, here's another one here. And then up there is a Frozen, like Disney princess Frozen. So I have 3 boxes of princess stuff that I need to sort through. So I want to get all of this stuff done today, so that tomorrow I can work on that all day and be ready for Friday. And Friday I don't have to be running around like crazy trying to get everything done. Tomorrow we'll just be putting things out. Okay, ready, set, go. This is me moving around the classroom. You don't need to see me do the whole room. I'll come back when it's done. But I need to clear that table before I can put these down. After this, I'm done and ready for my next class, and I'm done with that and can move on to the next thing. All right, so I didn't like the table setup twice, and I changed it for the third time, and I'm not gonna change it again because I'm running out of time. So, okay, let me tell you, got caught up here. I cleared off all the things on the top here. Put all the nail stuff away because we don't need it anymore. Tomorrow we're gonna do shaping. The students already have all their supplies, so I don't have to have anything out. All right, so for the tables, I did an L shape. So the students, and I'll record a little bit so you can see how they're gonna sit. They're gonna do somebody's hand and their opposite hand is gonna get done at the same time. So I kinda need like a circle. I couldn't really make it work. I don't have enough tablecloth. And so this weird L shape situation is where I ended up. So I did three tablecloths. I had to cut the corner so it will fold here. I put them just about to the end. I like them a little bit longer, but I needed it to fit, so that's about as far as I went. And then this third one here, I just cut down the middle so that way it would do that corner situation. So I think I'm gonna tape this down. I have a feeling that's not gonna last very long. And the tablecloths will get dirty, so I'm just gonna throw them away. They're from the Dollar Tree. They have them all the time. It's this little design. It's not very popular, so I always see this particular design there, or maybe it is popular and it's always there, but it's always in stock. Sometimes they go get purple or green or any other colors, and they're always out of, frequently out of colors, but I've always seen this one at the Dollar Tree. So perfect for Henna. I can always go back and get some more. Okay, so I've got these three done. I've got all my nail stuff here on my cart. I need to put it all in here. If it's, I've got 20 minutes to thaw. If I don't have time to do all of the things, I literally have just been kind of, been pushing it in here like randomly, and there's some like hidden back there. So I haven't like organized it, and I'm probably not going to just yet, but I need to put that away. But if I can't put it away, I'll keep it in here. And then I can just roll that cart over somewhere that direction behind my desk, get out of the way. So I got the poly plastics for special effects makeup. I'm excited about these, bringing these back. So when I'm putting things away, I'll put this in my special effects supplies, face painting and sculpting and airbrush makeup and all that. So I'll put stuff out like on top of that, like all my nail stuff is on top of there, and then that's on top of there, and I've got to wash that, but it's on top of the facial stuff. And then I found these really cute, I find if you get packages and things that are just cute, the students are more interested in them. So I found these really cute, they're the dry heat sanitizing baggies, and then I laminated my, what are these called? pH strip test sheets. So this is over my orientation cabinet that has all those things. So I put that there. So then that way I can get my keys and I can go ahead and just open up the cabinets and put that in there. So I went ahead and have put my table set up here. So they were supposed to go home and pick a hand. They're gonna draw on their model. They're gonna take their hand out. These I got a bunch of dollar store coloring books, and I just picked pages that I really liked, and then I made the copy of it to put in their packet. And then these are the ones from the dollar store. These I got on Amazon in bulk, so they have a makeup remover wipe, and then their pencil, they can choose black or brown, a sharpener, and then a napkin. So there are going to be shavings everywhere. I probably need to put out a purple mat so that they can work on top of the mat. Keeps the tablecloths a little bit cleaner, and they just throw their mat away with, yeah, I'm gonna put a purple mat out, because if not, they're gonna just shave, they're gonna not shave, they're gonna sharpen their pencils, and the shavings are gonna go everywhere, which they always do. There's always on the floor, and we step on them, and there's black streaks. Luckily, it's just makeup. I get makeup remover and remove that really quickly, and not a big deal, but I'm gonna go ahead and pull some of those bibs out. And what else? So I need to put that away. I updated my board, and this is a hot mess, so I need to come in here. The good thing about the closet is I can just close the door and no big deal. All right, so let me get to that and I'll check back in with you in a minute, and I'm gonna eat lunch as well. Let's go ahead and get started. You have your either scrubs or your smocks on. Please be careful on how you put your arms on your tabletop, as there is already eyeliner on the tabletop. Please be careful not to get your stuff dirty. Go ahead and you have washed your hands. Let's confirm that you have everything that you need on your tabletop. You have your henna pocket that is open to the hand of your choice that you are gonna draw on your neighbor. You have a cleansing wipe that you are gonna sanitize the skin before you start working on the skin. You have a makeup remover wipe that is nice and moist for you to use. If you mess up, you can just remove, and at the end you use it to remove the eyeliner from your arm. If you're gonna wash your hands, you need to use soap first, emulsify, and then add water, because if it's waterproof and you add water, then it's not really gonna go anywhere, okay? The next thing that you need is your eyeliner, either the brown or black pencil, or the liquid liner. Like I mentioned, the liquid liner is a little bit harder because you have to keep dipping the liner into the pot. I'm gonna be honest, those liners are from last year, so some are dry. Just toss it if it's dry. Some are still good. Then the eyeliner, you have to make sure to sharpen it. So with your napkin, make sure to sharpen over your napkin or over your purple mat. So that way the pencil shavings stay on top of your purple mat or your napkin, either one of the two will work just fine. So when it comes time to clean up, all you gotta do is take your mat or your napkin, roll it up, throw it away, and you're done. You don't have to like sweep or anything of the sort. Your phones are out, so you can take your pictures as you go along. If you will, take your name tag and make your name tags travel over to the front of here. I'll make a little pile and pass them, or I'll pick them up in just a minute. And everybody has washed their hands. All right. Make sure you have sharpened your pencil. Make sure you have sharpened your pencil. Your pencil's ready. Go ahead and open up your cleansing wipe and take the little paper out of the package and put it on top of the wipe. Then open up your makeup remover wipe. Take the little wipe and put it on top of your package just to have it ready, because your fingers are going to be busy in a minute. Make sure you have sharpened your liner. Now, some of these eyeliners, can you see this little hole right here? Where are we? Here. This little hole right here, that, you can pull that out. It's like a little, this little thing, you can pull it out and the hole gets bigger. It's just for different size eyeliners. So you can pull that little hole out and your eyeliner will fit. The eyeliners are a little, they got makeup on them, so your fingers will get dirty. Be careful not to touch your white smock with that. All right, so your pencil is ready. Go ahead and take your pencil and put it in your right hand. Do we have any left-handed people in here? Oh, nobody? Wow, okay. No left-handed for people? One? Okay, so you two. Okay, y'all are gonna struggle the first half, and then we're gonna switch, so don't worry. Today you're gonna use both hands. Everybody everybody put your writing utensil, whatever it is, in your right hand. Everybody hold, open both of the packages and put the little wipes on top of the package so it's ready to go, because in a minute your hands are going to be busy and you're not going to be able to have fingers to open your packages. So open the cleansing wipe and open your makeup remover wipe and put them on top of the packages, because in a minute you're not going to have both hands to open it. Just have them right there ready. Okay. Pencils are sharpened. Your wipes are out on top of their packages. Your paper is open to the drawing you want to do. Everybody's writing utensil is in your right hand, even if you're left-handed. Okay, take your left hand. Your left hand. Give it to the person to your left. Your left would be your left hand in front of her, to her. Your hand, switch writing utensils. Left hand to her. Switch writing utensils, put your pencil in that hand, and then give, yep. Put your, yep. Yep. Mm-hmm. Hold your writing utensil with your right hand, and you're gonna write on her hand. Give her, yep. And then your hand comes to her. You can. Okay, you are going to write with your right hand, even if you're left-handed, on the hand that was given to you. If you have a watch or a bracelet you don't want to get messed up or color on, just go ahead and take that off. If you will scoot to your left a tiny bit, you scoot to your left a tiny bit, you scoot to your left a tiny bit, and you can angle your chair just a little bit. That way, now this is like a weird corner. And if you scooch over to her shoulder so she can take her chair out, there you go. And that way your arm's not like all the way to the back, but you're slightly, I know it's a weird angle, sorry. You can lift the table towards you a little bit if you need. Okay? So your right hand is busy drawing, and your left hand belongs to your neighbor. Don't put it right here. Give it to the neighbor. And then don't be like this, right? Like soften your hand. They got to draw on it, okay? After a while, you're like this in your drawing and your hand starts to do like a weird turn. Keep it straight. They got to draw on it. Don't be shy and tell your neighbor, hey neighbor, stiffen your fingers, or don't stiffen your fingers, or hey, put it flat. You're gonna draw doing the design for half of the class using your right hand. And then I'm gonna stop you, and then we're gonna put the writing utensil in the opposite hand, and you're going to use the left hand, and you're gonna switch the other way. So you're gonna use both hands today, whether you're right-handed or left-handed. So it might be difficult in the beginning, and then easy at the end, or vice versa, okay? First, we've got to clean the client's hand. So her wipes are gonna be used on her. Her wipes are gonna be used on her, no matter if she's using them or she's using drawing, it doesn't matter. Your wipes you use on you, okay? Don't share wipes. The wipes belong to you. Don't share your cooties, thank you though. Okay, so take that person's wipe, wipe the hand, or you wipe it yourself, it doesn't matter. In the area, now you can use the back of the hand, you can draw on the back of the hand, or you can draw on the palm of the hand, you can fist the hand, you can draw on the, it's whatever. Okay, you have to talk to each other, you have to kind of like work together. If something's not working out, if something's uncomfortable, say, hey, let's try this, let's move here, let's work together. Okay? All right, I'm gonna put some music on. It's gonna take you a minute to kind of get the hang of it. You're gonna get started. I'm gonna stop you halfway, and then we're gonna switch. Switch hands. Okay, any questions? All right, whenever you are ready, you may go ahead and get started with your partner.
Wait, why don't miss Lemmy? Make sure my nose looks good, girl.
I'll get your good angle.
Oh my god, I hit the pencil in my mouth and I was about to try to sharpen it.
I can't do this.
It's upside down too, so it's hard.
I can do it.
All right, I literally thought you guys, let me turn the music off because I'm gonna get flagged. I literally, for real thought, no joke, that today was Thursday and tomorrow's Friday, so I'm telling the students, oh, it's spare day tomorrow. You don't have to wear your clothing, your scrub or smock, you can wear jeans and a Cosmo shirt, although the shirts have not come in yet. You're crooked, I'm sorry. But today's Wednesday. Tomorrow is Thursday. I need to get my eyelashes done. Like, I look crazy. I heard this girl on the internet say, it's on Instagram, she's overwhelmed with her house being all crazy. I feel her. And she said something like, she needed to put her lashes on because she didn't want to look like a naked mole rat. Yes. Good description there. Anyway, question. You have a sink, right? Like, I have a sink right here. When your students wash their hands, do they make a ridiculous mess and there's just puddles of water everywhere? Every day, every time. I'm like, and it's like they do this and like there's water everywhere. And I'm like, you know how to wash your hands? Ugh, I think we're gonna have a hand washing lesson. How do you wash your hands and how do you, cause then like all like there's water stains back here and it just all gets wet. And then if you're not paying attention, you put your belly on this here, then your belly gets wet. Oh yeah, yeah. We need to learn how to wash your hands. Anyway. All right. So I went ahead and someone left their packet here. I'm gonna put this here. So I've already got my stuff ready for tomorrow. Put the gloves out. I'm gonna put these away here in just a second. And then I have the bags out. So my table set up, I already have in my little bins, but I'm gonna go ahead and set up with the real henna, all the things. We are going to be covering the table. So the roll of paper is here. I told them to leave their trash here. Next time I think I'm gonna get an extra table covers and change them out per class period. Because there were shavings. So see like the shavings like this that stay on the chair. That they end up on the chair, and then when it's on the chair, then people get it on their pants. Anyway, so that is that. So I'm just rolling it up. I told them leave your trash there and I'm just gonna roll it up and toss that. And look, there's pencil shavings right here. And so there's some pencil shaving on the floor already. So I'm gonna go around and I'm gonna do a little bit of a spot clean to make sure we get all that stuff out. Okay, so what are we doing now? So I'm gonna come over here. I cleared my table. I'm going to take my little tray and voila, I'm ready for in the morning. I've got my notes. And I've got my little baggie with supplies that they know they're supposed to be needing. I'm missing a mask, so I need to get my mask. And my camera is set up and ready for tomorrow morning. And then for the afternoon, we're ready for there. All right, what else do we need to do? I need to get a mask. So over here, my little lazy Susan. And I've got my masks in here. I am ordering a... Oh, goodness. I'm gonna put you down. I am ordering a container that I'm gonna put on the wall for gloves and masks because right now I have it in this little, which I bought, which was great, but it doesn't really keep them I would say 100% sanitary because there's a hole in the box. So I'm gonna put something that I'm gonna order something that I'm put on the wall. So I got my mask because we're filing tomorrow. So I have that there and that's ready. So I'm going to finish cleaning up the tabletop. Then I'm going to put away these nail products and then I'm gonna tackle the closet because although I do have a lot of things that I need to do, my little pile is really growing. I need to sit at the computer. I really need to put the stuff away because I have like a block. If I have a mess or if there's a mess around me, I cannot function. I've got to clean up the mess before I can move on. So need to do that. So also I have Father Dodge Braid Workshop. So tomorrow my focus is gonna be on setting that up. All right, I believe that's it I have for you. That's all I have for you today. Thanks so much for tuning in and we'll see you on the next one.